here. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing my monthly favorites with you, which is kind of a hilarious tradition I have on my channel that every January, for some reason, I put out a favorites video. I think because like over the holidays in December, I tend to acquire a few new things as presents or gifts for myself, and my birthday's in November. So by January, I have some new things to share. But because I'm like a minimalist at heart, I just don't buy so much stuff over the year. So I always end up putting out these kind of videos in January and then not so often throughout the year. But I do put out plenty of like product reviews, toy reviews, that kind of thing. So let me know if you want to see more favorite videos, and I will try my hardest to put them out. If you like this one, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and hit that red subscribe button down below. My name is Marian. If you're new here, I make videos about being a mom and being a Jewish mom, and I'd love to have you as a subscriber. And if you want to follow along with my everyday life as a Jewish mom and see all the products I recommend on my Instagram, which I often do, don't forget to follow me there. Okay, so let's jump in. My January 2021 favorites for the year probably. These are things I've been loving the most, and I want to start with books. This book has changed my life already. I'm not even kidding, you guys. It like literally has. It's called Atomic Habits by James Clear. You've probably heard of it. It's a bestseller. I would say 3/4 of the way done, and I've honestly been saving it a little bit. So first of all, I bought a hardcover book, which if you know me and you've been following me, this is like the third one I've owned in my adult life because, like I said, I'm a minimalist at heart. I tend not to buy like physical books, but I spend so much time on my phone because I'm a, you know, social media person putting my life out there on Instagram and stuff like that, that I just wanted time away from my phone. And I also hate that my kids always see me on my phone, and it's part of my job. Like, that's just the reality of it. So, you know, it is what it is. But I was reading all the time my Kindle app on my phone. I was like, why don't I read an actual physical book? That way I'm not constantly on my little device. Anyways, so that's why I have a hardcover book here. And it's called Atomic Habits. It is all about how to instill little habits in your life that completely change your life. So got this book for the new year, which makes a lot of sense. I had some vague goals, like be a little healthier, eat a little healthier, exercise more. And this book is all about how to translate those super vague, like actually unreal expectations and goals into very real daily habits. And I have done it. It's been a month now, so I feel like I can say, you know, that I've really done it. Every day this month, I work out on the elliptical, meditate, and do yoga. If you know me, that's mind-blowing. Those are things I have not done probably since I was like getting ready for my wedding 7 years ago. And they have made the most enormous difference to my mental health. And my physical health too is getting there, but mostly for my mental health. But anyways, I also have instilled like other little habits like doing laundry every day. Oh, I really want you guys to read this. If you're looking for help in your life and how to improve your life with little things, this is such a helpful book on how to do it. Highly recommend. Next up in books, my really beautiful friend recommended me this one. It's called True You, and it's a journaling book. So it's just a bunch of journaling prompts. I don't want to show you because it's very private, but I've done a few of them already. And there's different chapters all about like identity, relationships, communities, passion, goals and dreams, life purpose. So if you want to get into a journaling practice, but you don't want to just like open a book and journal, if you find that hard, this is really good because there's themes and prompts. I also find they're like expansive enough that when there's a time I just want to write about something, I'll usually like find a place for it and just put it in this book so I have it all together. But I am loving doing this. Again, it's just away from my phone, away from my device, take a mental break. This has been really, really nice. So I want to recommend this. And of course, I'm not going to talk about books without talking about my own. It's available for pre-order. Obviously, it's my favorite thing in the world. It's coming out March 23rd, Expecting Jewish, How to Add the Blessing of Judaism to the 9 Months of Pregnancy. So check it out. Okay, up next is a fashion item, if we could call it that. And these are these boots. These are the UGG Adirondacks. I have been wanting these for maybe a decade, ever since I moved to the East Coast. If you ever have cold feet and you live in the East Coast or anywhere cold, you get it. It's kind of ruins your time outside when you're cold. And because this year I am doing nothing besides spending time outdoors or in my own house, obviously not going in any places, I really want it to be warm. So basically I'm doing like outdoor park, playing in the park with my son, and it's 30 degrees outside, outdoor Tat Shabbat, and it's 30 degrees outside. And I just realized that what would make the whole experience bearable for myself was to not be cold. So I invested in these. They're about $175, but I just highly recommend them. I hope to have them for the next decade. So far they've worn really well. They're super light, which is a huge thing with like big heavy snow boots. These are not heavy. They're super light. They're really easy to wear and comfortable, and they're all like sheer lined and super warm. So these have made a huge difference to my winter experience. Okay, next up I want to talk about two kids things because I'm a mama at heart, of course, as you know. And the first is this Yeti water bottle. So I know what you're probably thinking, like, you got your kid a Yeti water bottle? Yes, before I even got myself any Yeti products. My kids love these and they're so easy to wash. I'm such a thing about washing the bottles because I hate when they get the mold in them. This only has 3 parts, the top, the straw, and the actual bottle, which makes it so much easier to wash. The bottle brush goes right in it. It's very easy to keep clean and keeps water cold or hot as needed. So we've been a huge fan of these. We've been using them now over 6 months. Long time, since the summer. And I just got a second one for my younger son. So we are loving the Yeti water bottles. If you're looking for something for your kids that doesn't like get moldy and gross, and that is super like tough and long lasting, I recommend this. I was also gonna show you guys my Yeti coffee cup, but I can't find it, but I'm loving that one too. Okay, next up in kids stuff are these toys. I mentioned these, I think, over the holidays. My best friend's a preschool teacher and she sent these to me, and they have been a huge hit in our house. So they're magnetic ball and stick toys. You can use them to build. My kids actually use them very imaginatively. They pretend that they're like ice cream and popsicles and doctor bandages. I was really surprised because they're not so imaginative in how they play all the time, but for some reason this toy really inspires them in that way. So you can use it to build, you can use it for anything. This is actually a separate set by a different brand, but I put them together because they all fit. So these are like animal ones. But we have been loving these in our house. I wanted to recommend them. They're not too expensive. They're long lasting, like well made toys, and really fun. I don't know what they're called, but I will link them down below along with everything else I talk about. Okay, next up, I want to talk about apps, and this is my favorite one. It's called Insight Timer. Basically, it is a guided meditation app. There also are like courses and yoga and music and other things in that realm, but I use it for guided meditation. There's live events that happen and all these like community building things, but I just pick a meditation to do every night with it. And yes, I've been meditating every night. It's amazing. I actually used to meditate without any sort of guide, which I still do sometimes, but I've really been loving this. And what's nice about this app, so if you go to guided meditations, there's all sorts of like beginner kits to get started if you're looking for managing stress, coping with anxiety, learning to meditate. But what I like to do every time is I filter by time. I usually do 15 minutes and then I'll filter again by like what mood I'm in by benefit. So we can do like depression, pain, stress, motivation, relaxation, sleep, whatever you're looking for help with. And then the meditations that pop up will all be geared to that. And it says like how long they are, who does them. So once you find a person or like a voice you really like, you can do more of their meditations. And I just love it. It also like tracks a little bit. So I've done 308 minutes of meditation this year and 5 consecutive days. But I actually have meditated every day. I just sometimes don't use the app. Anyways, so I like that it kind of has that progress aspect to it if you're into that kind of thing. But yeah, I really recommend this. It's called Insight Timer. I'll link it down below. I do not have the paid version, although there is one which has a little more bells and whistles, but for now I'm just using the free one to see how I go with it. And the last thing I want to recommend are TV shows. We just finished watching an Israeli movie or series called Valley of Tears. I don't know if I want to recommend it or not. I do want to recommend it. It was a brilliant, really, really well-made series. It's about the Yom Kippur War in Israel, but I will just say it is extremely emotional, sad, and depressing. It's really, really, really sad. I kept watching because it's so addictive. It's total like binge-worthy TV and so well-made, but I kept like waiting for something good to happen. I'm not giving any spoiler alerts, but let's just say it's pretty dark. But if you like war movies and super intense drama, and if you like Israeli films, then this one was really, really, really good. So that was our most recent binge watch, which I do want to recommend with just the caveat that your mind's got to be in the right place for it. So that is everything. Those are my 2021 favorites so far. I hope you guys like this video. Chat with me in the comments. Let me know what you think. I'd love to hear from you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.